One of the most popular spring vegetables around these days is asparagus. Often thought as being a fern, it was originally classified as a lily, only recently being identified as a unique plant family all on its own. The new shoots of asparagus are harvested in the springtime and used as a steamed vegetable with amazing flavour. It wasn't always considered just being a food source though. Its medicinal qualities are great and it's well known as being a diuretic, which means it promotes the production of urine, which flushes your body of excess fluids, cleansing it. Now, it also has a complex base of minerals and vitamins to it, including two really important ones, chromium, which helps insulin store excess glucose in your cells, basically gives you more energy. And the other one, selenium. Now, there's all sorts of good things that selenium's associated with, but one thing that it does is it fights against cell oxidization. It might well be one of the cures in the future for cancer. So we know it tastes good and we know that it's good for us, but where do you get it? Well, the good news is just 25 minutes out of the city of Perth, in Bickley Valley, in the Perth Hills, you'll find the most amazing asparagus farm. Now, Petra and Harry Smeets have been growing asparagus here for about 7 years. And I thought it was such a great opportunity to have a chat to them and find out how they do it. Harry, the asparagus farm's amazing. How many plants have you got here?
Be about 20,000, 25,000.
Wow. Yeah, so. And with a mature plant, so at 3 years old, what kind of crop would you expect to start to harvest each year?
You go from about half a kilo to a kilo per plant. It varies with the green one a bit less, the white produces a bit more.
Uh-huh. So, actually, I wanted to ask you that question because there's the purple and the green. But you guys, you also grow the white asparagus, which I've seen in Europe a lot, but not here.
No, we're one of the only ones here. I believe we're the only ones in Western Australia. It's a bit hard here because we've got different soils than in Europe.
Yeah.
But we found a way around it, so it's it's going quite well.
The white asparagus is grown in blackout tunnels with no light, and therefore it can't produce chlorophyll, which means no green colour. If you love asparagus and you want to grow it yourself at home, well, here's the guide to what you've got to do. Make sure you plant them in a beautiful, open, sunny spot like this. If you can create a furrow like this, so water runs down to it, it's going to be more efficient, and you'll find that drip irrigation is a terrific way to irrigate them. It goes down nice and deep, and this encourages those corms, which is the roots where all those shoots will come from, well, it basically gets them bigger quicker. Don't go harvesting anything for 3 years, and in the third year, in the spring, you'll be able to start picking some beautiful new spears. Now, if you can't be bothered growing it, there's another easy way. You can come up here to the Bickley Valley Asparagus Farm, or you can buy it from the local Kalamunda Farmers Market. It's that easy.